Ryzen 7000 series desktop CPU launch is just weeks away. AMD has officially revealed a lot of information about these upcoming processes. But the most important things, such as full specs, exact release date and time, and performance are only known through unofficial information channels. I don't like waiting for the official information as the curiosity always gets the best of me. So, I have gathered all the latest leaks on the Ryzen 7000 series processors and will share it all with you in this video. It should allow you to start planning your next build or an upgrade. But first, an ad from a sponsor. Buy your Windows 10 or 11 key for less from cdkeyoffer.com at the link in the description below. Use code IV20 to get a 25% discount that brings the price down to as low as $16. You can securely check out with PayPal and receive your Windows key in minutes, ready to be activated on your PC. Let's start with comparing Ryzen 7000 to 5000 series specs. FYI, there is no 6000 series on the desktop platform as AMD decided to skip that number. There are four major changes coming to Ryzen 7000. Those are a move from TSMC 7nm to 5nm manufacturing process, a much higher core clock frequency, larger cache, and higher power consumption. But it does not mean that AMD is abandoning power efficiency trend it has set in the previous years. Expect the increased TDP to translate into significant performance gains. Surprisingly, AMD decided to keep the number of cores in 7000 series the same as in 5000 series. That is 6 cores 12 threads in Ryzen 5 7600X, 8 cores 16 threads in Ryzen 7 7700X, 12 cores 24 threads in Ryzen 9 7900X, and 16 cores 32 threads in the top Ryzen 9 7950X. Yes, those are the official product names that were already unofficially confirmed by AMD when they were recently added to AMD Resource Library. You may have noticed that there is no mention of Ryzen 7 7800X. This model should also have 8 cores and 16 threads, the same as 7700X. There is a possibility that 7800X will be launched separately at a later date. Or maybe AMD wants to keep those high-quality 8-core chips to make 7800X 3D, to absolutely destroy Intel's upcoming 13th-gen processors in gaming applications. 3D at the end of the name means that this product is using AMD's 3D V-Cache technology that was first seen in Ryzen 7 5800X 3D, which proved to be a very good gaming CPU. Even compared to Intel's latest and greatest i9-12900K, which costs significantly more. Now, let's have a closer look at how individual Ryzen 7000 processors compare to their 5000 series equivalents, starting with the Ryzen 5 7600X. It is a 6-core 12-thread CPU with 4.7 GHz base core clock and 5.3 GHz boost, which is a massive improvement compared to 3.7 GHz base and 4.6 GHz boost on 5600X. The cache is also slightly larger at 38MB versus 35MB. One change that I expect some people will not like is 105 watts TDP, which is a lot higher than 65 watts on 5600X. But that is the price you have to pay to have such high core clock frequency, which is certainly helping the 7600X achieve insane levels of performance, as proven by the recent user benchmark result of a Ryzen 5 7600X engineering sample that is 22% better than i9-12900K in single-core test. Obviously, 7600X loses in the multi-core test, due to having fewer threads. However, if we are talking about gaming, then having fewer but faster cores is better. At this point, I am sure that we will see 7600X beat all the current flagship CPUs in gaming while costing a lot less. Also, bear in mind that this test was done using an engineering sample, so the final retail version of the 7600X that you will be able to buy soon may perform even better. Ryzen 7 7700X has 8 cores and 16 threads, featuring 4.5 GHz base and 5.4 GHz boost with 40 MB of cache. Again, that is quite a big frequency increase even compared to 5800X with its 3.8 GHz base and 4.7 GHz boost. TDP remains the same at 105 watts. Ryzen 9 7900X with 12 cores and 24 threads will have 4.7 GHz base, 5.6 GHz boost and 76 MB of cache. TDP has increased from 105 watts to 170 watts compared to 5900X. I expect 7900X to become an extremely popular choice among high-end gaming PC builders as long as it keeps the price way below $600. AMD's new AM5 platform will end up supporting the next 3 or 4 generations of CPUs. So it is a good choice if you like having an easy CPU upgrade path in the future. That is something you don't get with Intel. The upcoming 13th gen will be the second and the last CPU generation to use LGA 1700 motherboards. Ryzen 9 7950X is the top model with the highest core count among Ryzen CPUs at 16 cores and 32 threads. The core clock frequency is 4.5 GHz base and 5.7 GHz boost. I think we will see it overclock to 6 GHz using regular coolers at home. Those frequencies are quite a bit better than 3.4 GHz base and 4.9 GHz boost on 5950X. The cache is getting an increase from 72 MB to 80 MB. But the most notable change is 170 watts TDP versus 105 watts on 5950X. It will be interesting to see by how much AMD improved the performance on Ryzen 9 7950X compared to the previous generation. I expect it to be huge, as this is supposed to be the CPU that is much better than Intel's upcoming i9-13900K, which features 24 cores and 32 threads. FYI, 13900K is 30-40% stronger than 12900K in multi-core workloads thanks to that core count increase. Now onto the most important part. When will we be able to see the reviews and buy Ryzen 7000 processors? The product announcement is set to happen on August 29th at 8 PM Eastern Time in the US. That is 1 AM on August 30th in London, UK time. The press embargo is set to expire on September 13th at 9 AM Eastern Time in the US or 2 PM London, UK time for any of my fellow Europeans. This means that we will see Ryzen 7000 CPU and X670 motherboard reviews start going live at this time. The sales will begin 2 days later, on September 15th at 9 AM Eastern Time or 2 PM London UK time, so not too long left to wait. If you are planning to buy a new PC or upgrade your current build, then I recommend waiting for the Ryzen 7000 processors if you can. It is well worth it, as the new generation will bring much better performance at a similar price. One thing to consider though, Ryzen 7000 processors do not support DDR4 memory, so you will have to splash some cash on DDR5, which is still quite a bit more expensive than I would like to see it. On the other hand, DDR5 prices keep dropping and it does offer superior performance, so it may be a worthwhile purchase when the time comes, especially for a high-end PC build. But if you want to stick with DDR4, then you have an option to wait for Intel to release 13th gen processors, which will support both DDR4 and 5, and are expected to hit the shelves in October. Do you like what Ryzen 7000 has to offer? Or would you pick Intel 13th gen? As always, I am waiting for you in the comments to have a discussion about it. And if you enjoyed this video, then you know what to do. It was I, Vadim. Until next time.